Haha, you missed it.
Groundbreaker's safe from melting to bits now. Lots of good people can rest easy because of you.
Oh, thanks. It's nothing. How do you do that?
Yes, you caught me ruminating again. Guilty as charged. What's occupying your thoughts?
Absolutely nothing. This is not the way back, is it? I'll just drop down.
It's time to reevaluate my career, Gold.
Maybe.
Temps are lowering across the station. Anyone outside is getting a hell of a light show from the droplet arrays. Thanks
really?
For the help. Let me know if you ever need to borrow a wrench or something.
Will do.
If something's broke, fill out an incident report.
You keep the yellow Halcyon News. We interrupt your
nothing's broke.
Advertisement for the following
rather, it's fixed.
My boards are returning to green. What a weight that is off my shoulders. I don't normally tolerate outsiders mucking about in my station's guts, but you're all right.
Tolerate? You told me to.
The should be dropping as we speak. I'll see to it the crew knows who kept us all from boiling alive. If you've got time, I believe Edna has a comms issue that could use your attention. I've also authorized Doc and Furu to sell you our premium meds.
Premium meds? I get it. Welder's goggles. Huh. Reputation increased. Okay, Edna has a comms issue. Groundbreaker are now friendly. Alright, thanks. We'll be on our way. So who's... Stellar Bay. It's not that. So I need to talk to... What's her name? Edna! Hi!
You aiming to send a message? If so, we best do it now while we still got time.
Why would we run out of time? Are you headed somewhere?
Me? No. But our relaying capabilities? That's on the final countdown. We're going offline in 3, 2, 1.5... No. Wait, I've lost track of my weeks. Maybe it was 36 or... sometime dire soon.
Yeah. Why are you about to lose comm capabilities?
Our primary relay station's soon to be occluded by a gas giant. Happens every 40 years or thereabouts.
Oh.
The event's forecasted to last for months, during which we'll lose signal to the station.
And that's our problem, how?
We've got backup auxiliary relays, but the one currently in orbital range went offline some months ago. We can't spare people for routine maintenance.
How are you cut off by losing one relay station? Because the thing's gonna be in the way.
Well... We wouldn't be utterly and completely blacked out, but we'd lose the majority of our comm traffic for sure. Ships and colonies on Terra 2 need a clear line from their communications towers to the Groundbreaker for the transmissions to make it through. If it's not clear, they transmit to the closest relay station, which stores the message, then passes it along when our orbits align.
So first you want to know if I need to send a message, but you actually want help with me helping other people send and receive messages. What about the other auxiliary relay stations?
The others won't be in orbital range during the occlusion event. Isn't it some law of the universe? The relay I gotta rely on is, of course, the one on the Fritz.
Can't ships relay messages to each other?
That they can, and they do. But only between ships owned by the same corporation. No corporal authorized sending messages through a ship owned by a rival.
Jeez.
And no corporal relay messages for the Wildcat freighters. Not without charging them more than they'll make in a single haul, anyway. That's why we're the message hub. The Groundbreaker's neither corporate-owned nor board-controlled. Our comms are neutral.
Not board-controlled, but can't the board handle the messages?
Sure. I mean, they got their own relays and all, but they'll only send along messages the corporations pay for. And then they charge folks to send messages back, often more than they can afford. And none of that money goes to the Groundbreaker. Just tightens the board's grip on our throat.
Don't you charge people for messages too?
Not nearly as much, and that money goes to keeping the station operational. Helps keep us independent. If we lose the message fees, the entire ship will feel the pinch. Before long, the only place for people to trade words and goods will be on Terra 2, right under the board's control. That'd spell the end of Groundbreaker.
Alright, well, sounds like it's time to get the auxiliary station back online then.
Yeah, I'm working on it. I finally got the chief to approve the budget for a diagnostic expedition. But allocating the personnel loss for sending a technical team to the relay station keeps getting denied by Junlei. The chief.
What's in it for me if I investigate your relay problem?
You save my comm center from chaos. I guarantee I'll get the chief to authorize some payment forms with your name on them while you're out fixing the station.
Payment forms. I could check out the relay. No need for official sign-off in that case.
I should say no, but why not? Maybe you can figure out why it's offline. I'll send you with an equipment manual. Hopefully we'll get lucky, or I'll get my approval in time.
Huh. Hope you don't mind if I borrow that manual when you're done with it, Captain. I could do with some leisure reading.
Absolutely.
Oh, and I'll need you to retrieve a copy of the relay's backup data. I gotta forward any messages from Earth stored in the memory. Better late than never, eh?
You just let messages from Earth sit in memory on an orbital relay?
It's not like they're in high demand. Most tend to be adverts on new products, meaning only folks in Byzantium can afford them.
Oh.
I'm sure the station's got a stack of junk messages just waiting for me to sort through.
Alright, I'm off then. One quest done and just got another one. The Groundbreaker's primary communications relay station is about to be occluded by one of Halcyon's gas giants for the next few months. To avoid being entirely cut off, they need the old backup relay station operational again. Edma Ingmir in communications hired you to travel to relay GB-23 and bring the station online. The Groundbreaker's backup communications relay went offline a while ago. Now that the station's primary relay is going to be occluded, this backup relay must be repaired. Okay. Well, this science weapon. We need to find that. Alright. So, okay, there's two of them. Objective. I see one objective. But here I see two. This one's closer, though. Because one's supposed to be here. The other one's probably leading me to the... my ship. Behind here, or...
This is Halcyon News. We interrupt your regularly scheduled advertisement for the following.
You have one. You have one of these?
Have you had a moment to look into that little opportunity I told you about on Roseway?
No.
You don't hurry up. Someone will get to snooping around there before you do. Won a charming copper kettle off that girl who runs the pub. She's a fierce arm wrestler. But she's no match for your pal Gladys.
Hmm. Okay. Wow. That's pretty nice. What am I supposed to be finding? Looking in Gladys's shop for old records. Apparently the smuggler acquired several leads that way. Where are these old records?
It's almost time for today's episode of The Chairman's Children. Care to listen with me?
No, that's okay.
I found a handsome ceramic mandap...
Records. An old data pad. Once used by the Groundbreaker's Mardet security forces, from the accumulated dust and grime, this hasn't been accessed for over a decade. Down on their luck, smugglers will often purchase old data pads in the hope of finding clues to a forgotten cache of goods they can sell. I can just buy this stuff. And this Hephaestus mining active cartridge. This data cartridge contains the public records of Hephaestus mining outpost on Scylla. It can be viewed using the captain's terminal on the Unreliable. Like accounting figures, most companies keep two sets of data records, public and private. Wildcat miners often purchase the public records of failed mining outposts, hoping to uncover details on remaining ore veins that are too small for a corporation to consider profitable. Okay, I bought it, now I'm reading it. The old data pad contains incident reports from various Mardet security patrols. Most are details of simple finds and dust-ups between the crews of Wildcat freighters and corporate haulers. Two entries have been marked for later review. August 7th, 2344, responded to a code ID 10T at the Lost Hope. Vera asked us to bounce some Back Bay rat that got himself soaked in Spectrum Red. Drunken fool got into a scuffle with one of Engineer Tennyson's people. We tossed the rung leech back down to the bays. Asshole fought us the entire way, telling us we'd be sorry once he controlled the hammer's power. Is this some new Hammersmith marketing stunt? Oh, if this is some new Hammersmith marketing stunt, I'm complaining to Sunita. October 25th, 2344. Had another run-in with the rung leech from the Last Hope. Lost Hope, sorry, I keep saying that. Don't know how the uppity piker crawled out of the back bays without us noticing, locked himself into the repair bay off of docking slip 13 and refused to come out. Kept raving about the weapon's chaotic beauty or some crap while we were trying to talk him out. Had to break off when our ship ended. Hullhead's gotta come out eventually. Is that what we're looking for? I don't know. And the mining cartridge. Okay, I guess that was it. Review the Hephaestus Mining Archive on Hawthorne's Terminal. Okay, will do. So it's this log, the Mordet data pad. Oh yeah. A data cartridge acquired from Gladys on Groundbreaker may have clues to another science weapon's location. Use the captain's terminal on the unreliable to review the data archive. Okay. Will do. And Phineas has a powerful weapon in his orbital lab. Maybe we should go visit him next. I'm guessing that's the old records we're looking for that we just found. To the security office. We'll turn in our bounty here. Hi. Can I talk to you through this?
How goes the hunt? I've been ruminating on it, and I decided, if you ain't killed MacRedd yet, I want you to hurt him a little before you do. Nothing excessive, mind you, but the scoundrel deserves a light beating at least before he kicks off.
Sure, good news, I killed Captain MacRedd and I roughed him up before I did him in. Actually, I just threw grenades at him. If that counts as roughing up, sure.
I believe I'm growing fond of you, bounty hunter.
Oh, a smile.
You got the Mardets' backs, the Mardets have got yours. Here's the bounty payout. Nice work down there. With any luck, we can hire more sharp-eyed bounty hunters like you in the future.
Okay, we're getting experience. $12.50. Bit cartridges is to give us the toxin-free stuff. They are now revering. Nice. Any more bounties available?
With that bastard MacRedd dead, there ain't much else in the offing. Not that I'm complaining, mind you.
Red dead. Okay, I'll be on my way. Woo! Always gives me a rush, you know. All right. More skills and perks. I need some leadership here. Okay. Perks. All right, we now have access to tier 2. While moving. Okay. Tactical time dilation meter when you kill an enemy. 50% science weapon damage. Movement speed. While tactical time dilation is active. Increase weak spot damage. That sounds nice too. Increasing the range. I haven't looked directly at them. I'm good with that. Vendor prices. When you critically hit a target, you have a chance of immediately resetting the cooldown of a companion ability. Killing an enemy reduces the remaining cooldown time. I tend to kind of just let my people do their thing. Killing an enemy reduces the remaining cooldown time of companion abilities. Restore some health whenever you kill an enemy. That's could be useful. Consumable weight. Increasing carrying capacity. Bonus from companions. Bonus to dialogue skills when you have no companions in your party. I pretty much plan on always having companions in my party. Health. Headshot, weak spot damage. Well, I actually have to try to make headshots, which I don't do a lot. Let's take this for now. Probably go for either dialogue skills or headshot weak spot damage next time. Yosh. Alright, we gotta get back to the Unreliable to look at that log.
Hey, be careful with those crates, huh? My car.
Yeah. I know she's not talking to me. So it looks like it would be
more. Any more strains while you were out? I suppose if the crew's quarters fill up, we could hang hammocks in the cargo hold.
No, I didn't pick up any more strays. I have something we need to listen to. Reviewing a data archive to another science weapons location. All right.
Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance?
Okay, I guess. The Captain's Terminal. Oh, the Captain's Terminal. Search Hephaestus Mining Archive cartridge for keyword weapon. Keyword search results. Result number one. From the site supervisor's personal logs. That captain sold Harris something called the Rearranger, then left before he discovered the damn thing doesn't work. Only thing, it rearranges a number of bits on Harris's cart. Looks like some strange tech or a weapon. Maybe a scientist can make something of it? Result number two. From the site safety officer's incident report. Doc Caulfield couldn't save Lem. Now I gotta arrest Harris for his murder. Confiscated that weapon he used and stored it in Birdie's office for now. Figured the least the site supervisor can do is fill out the forms for whatever that damn thing is. Don't know how I'm gonna detain Harris. Not like we got prison cells in this rock. So Harris killed Lem. And the weapon is stored in Birdie's office. Result number three from Barber's coronary inquest. Oh, that's right. The barber in the, what do you call it? The town that we were just in. They do that thing. They spiffy up the corpses. Given name Lemuel. Okay, Lem, short for Lemuel. Family name Harryford. Employment status indentured. Indentured servitude. Contract term 35 years, 2 months, 16 days, 5 hours, 33 minutes, approximate remaining. Oh my god. This was a kindness. Time of deceasement 18:27 hours, approximate. Cause of deceasement blunt force trauma. Weapon unknown. Took a good whack to the noggin. The facial area, to be specifical about it. It's all twisted up, too. Specifical? Nose is 5 times too big. Jaw is shrunk to almost nothing. Teeth are all out of kilter, though I suppose that was true pre-deceasement. If the blow itself didn't kill him, there's no way he could have breathed with all that damage. You see the way this blurs like this? Is this due to the where it's like a flickering. I don't know if it's because of that. still kind of blurry. Yeah, I'm not sure. I'm not sure what effect that has. Alright, I don't know. I mean, it... In theory, I understand. Distort and shift the colors on screen. But why would we want to do that? Does it look cool or something? Or does it achieve some kind of effect with colors? I don't know. Anyway, I turned it off for now. Let me know if you guys prefer it on, off, or you don't care. I'm not sure what to do about it. Alright, so... We reviewed... So I reviewed the data archive. I'm not sure where were these people? Does it say? Hephaestus. Did I hit the... I think I hit my, what do you call it? My inhaler. Yeah, this is... what we read about. Hammer's power. I still don't know why I would have her logs. I mean, I wouldn't willingly check her messages. Although I did, I didn't know it was for her, and I read it anyway, didn't I? I didn't back out of it. Let's see if anyone has anything else to say. Hi.
This roseway business smells.
Does it?
Something tells me things didn't end well for the guy who made the distress call, and whoever or whatever got him will be waiting for us.
What are you suggesting?
Just a little caution. Could be a reason no one's picked up this job yet.
Good thinking.
They don't give medical degrees to dummies, Captain. Anyway, we might as well take a look out there. See if we can get the jump on whoever's waiting for us.
We're definitely gonna be checking it out.
Something on your mind?
Oh, she's filled in the place a little bit. Right? Oh no, that was here. Mysterious bottle of hooch. Yeah, this stuff was here. It is pretty Spartan.
Good to see you, boss.
Never mind, sorry. Now, I can't give them the stuff I want for them until they join my party, and I can't have them join my party until we leave somewhere.
The ship used to be much quieter.
Sorry, I got people here now. There's Parvati. Yeah. That's gone.
Felix keeps asking me to watch some adventure serial with him. It's not my thing, but he's real sweet about it.
Okay. Ah. Okay. Don't think I'll do that again. So I think we'll go visit Phineas next. I would like to visit Phineas. Yeah, I think we'll go pay him a visit before we head to one of these places. I think maybe repairing the signal might be a good thing to do. Might be a short little thing. Repairing the signal relay or whatever. But we'll go visit Phineas and we'll see if we can find out anything about the shrink ray. Maybe someone can distract him. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.